everyone. So, today here we meet up again. Welcome to the Meso Study Chemistry Sessions. So, I hope everybody is doing super fine and are you ready to discuss with me a very special kind of isomerism, that is the tautomerism. Why this is special? Because it is nothing but a very special kind of isomerism depicting a special equilibrium. So that is what tautomerism is. This very topic is very, very important from your examination point of view. It holds a hell lot of weightage in every exam, whether it is NEET, whether it is JEE or CBSE. So this very topic out here is very, very, very important. You need to pay attention in this session as I'll be discussing certain questions regarding the same. So just pick up your pens, papers, whatever you have, and just try to follow me. Let us just start off with the tautomerism. So, what is tautomerism? As I told you, it's a special kind of dynamic equilibrium. It is nothing but dynamic equilibrium. And why it is known as dynamic equilibrium? Because here the isomers are present in equilibrium positions. So what is happening over here? Let us just take up an example. Then after that, I'll explain you the definition. So the example here I'm taking is of acetone. What is acetone? We all know that is propanone, and I need to have an equilibrium. How can I represent this acetone in the equilibrium? So if I try to represent this methyl group in certain other way, what kind of other way? I am just showing this hydrogen certain separately. Now, what do I need to do? If you see over here, there is a special kind of interaction between this hydrogen and this oxygen. Now, what will be happening? This hydrogen migrates towards the oxygen. So, the hydrogen over here, it is migrating. So I hope everybody is following me. I have taken a very simple example of acetone, and this acetone can be represented, the hydrogen can be represented separately. The hydrogen then is attracted somewhat towards the oxygen. So what happens? The hydrogen migrates, and what do we get? In order to maintain the number of electrons, in order to maintain the number of bonds in the entire structure, what has happened? A double bond has come over here. So I hope everybody has got it. Now from this very example, what do I observe? So let us just try to write our observations. So what do you observe? I observe here that the hydrogen is migrating. So there is H migration. And what kind of hydrogen? It is nothing but the alpha hydrogen over here. That is the alpha carbon, a carbon which is just adjacent to the main functional group, that is alpha carbon over here. And this is alpha hydrogen. So what is migrating? Hydrogen is migrating. What kind of hydrogen? Alpha hydrogen. Also, if you observe in this entire structure, the number of electrons always remains the same. The number of electrons as you count the number of bonds. So it is always, always the same. What changes is the position of electrons changes. So, position of electrons changed, but number of electrons always remain the same. So you need to pay a very proper attention over here, because I'll be discussing questions at the end of the session which are very important from your NEET as well as JEE point of view. So just pay attention over here. So what do I observe is, I have got hydrogen migration, I have got alpha hydrogen that is migrated. Position of the electrons have changed because I have got changed bonds, but the number of electrons always remains the same. And that is nothing but the entire definition of tautomerism. So that is what we call as tautomerism. So in tautomerism, there is a kind of a dynamic equilibrium existing. What kind of a dynamic equilibrium? Equilibrium between the two forms. If you see here, why I'm saying this is dynamic? Because if you compare it with the word static, it is not static. It is continuously moving in one direction, then the other, and then vice versa. So that is why I'm calling it as the dynamic equilibrium. And also, that is the only reason it is known as the dynamic isomerism. So that is having dynamic equilibrium, as I told you. You may be finding out various other names for tautomerism. It could be desmotropism. So that is desmotropism. Or you could be finding other names like cryptotropism. Allotropism, etc., etc. So you need not go by these words. These words do not hold relevance as per your examination. You just need to remember what tautomerism is and why there is an equilibrium between the forms. Now I would like to introduce to one more term by which we call the tautomerism. That term is nothing but keto-enol tautomerism. So most importantly, tautomerism is also known as keto-enol tautomerism. So I hope everybody is falling out here. And what else I need to tell you over here about the tautomerism is, it is a kind of a structural isomerism. So we know what structural isomerism is, where the molecular formula remains the same, but there are different kinds of structures. So that is the simplest definition for tautomerism, you can say. So it is related to same molecular formula, but different structures. And we have already discussed that why we have got different structures in tautomerism. So now let's move on to the keto-enol tautomerism. Nothing but what we have just discussed. So how do we call it as the keto-enol tautomerism? So I have got a ketone here. So I'll be discussing this, that is number one. Number two is, I'll be discussing the case. I'm taking up very, very simple examples just to make you understand what really the concept is. So now I'll be taking up another, that is what? That is aldehyde, ethanol. So I've taken up two forms. One is ketone and one is aldehyde. Again, Can I migrate the hydrogen? Can you see any kind of alpha hydrogens out here? I have got it. So it is, these are the alpha hydrogens present. Again, these are the alpha hydrogens. You need to be very careful while observing the alpha hydrogens out here, because only and only the alpha hydrogens will be responsible for this particular isomerism and nothing else. Over here, can you see in the aldehyde again alpha hydrogens? Yes. I've got the alpha hydrogens out here. Now, how can I represent the shifting, the migration of the hydrogen? So, we have already discussed in this particular case, that is how we make the migration of hydrogen in acetone. So, it would be, if I just write this hydrogen in the other ways, that is somewhat like this. So, what do I get? I get an interaction between the oxygen and the hydrogen. I hope that is clearly visible to you. Now, again, there will be the shifting of hydrogen here. And what will happen now? Instead of this very particular double bond, what do we have it as? We have the double bond over here, and that is how the tautomerism is taking place. OH. So it's quite simple. You just need to shift the hydrogen and shift the double bonds. So that is what you need to do. Shift the hydrogen and shift the double bonds. That will be the isomer, the another kind of isomer which will be existing in the equilibrium. Now if I move on to over here in the aldehyde case, can I do the same thing? Yes. But over here I'll be considering this very particular carbon, because this hydrogen is not alpha. So do not get confused by this hydrogen. This is not taking part in the tautomerism. Now what will happen? Again a similar kind of representation I need to have. That is how you are going to do. And I hope everybody is trying to make the structure simultaneously with me. That is how the H bonding or the migration or the interaction will be taking place. Again, what do I get? I need to shift the hydrogen and shift the electrons, shift the bonds. CH2 over here, a doubly bonded carbon, OH and H. And there you go. You get the isomer. Now, what is the relevance of keto-enol form? Let us just discuss that. It's quite simple. So here, if you see, what is the keto group here? The keto group is always this particular group out here. So if you see, let me just highlight that. That is the keto group. Again, I've got a keto group here. The keto group is converted into enol. Now, what is enol? If you just break that down, en plus ol, that means it is containing a double bond, that is en, and ol means alcohol. So that is what it is making the enol form. So it is en plus ol giving out enol. So simple. So many of you might be having certain confusions about tautomerism. It is quite easy concept. You need to have just little logics in your mind to perform such kind of equilibriums. So here I have got what? I've got in keto form, that is keto form having the keto groups and the enol form. So that is why we call it as keto enol form, or simply the tautomerism. I hope everybody has got it. It was quite simple definition. I just need to shift the hydrogens and shift the bonds. So that is what you need to do. So I hope you are clear with the fact. Now let's just move on to one step ahead. Can we have different kinds of carbonyls? So let us just look at that. So I need to now find out which all will be giving the key to enol tautomerism or not. So here is a question for you. I need to have, so decide or find out which one will show keto-enol tautomerism. So I've got two options for you. Number one is this. I'm using a different method out here. First, I'm taking up the questions, then I'll be telling you the concept. So that is what we are going to do here as well. So that is the first option. I hope everybody has written this down. What is the second option we have got? So that is the second option that we have. Out of the two, you need to find out which one will give keto-enol and which one will not. So again, what you need to do, look for the alpha hydrogens and you'll be getting your answer. So over here, if you observe, what are the alpha carbons out here? So this is the main carbon. What is the alpha carbon? This is the alpha carbon. What are the alpha hydrogens? There are no alpha hydrogens present over here. The carbons are having three methyls instead. That means the hydrogens, the alpha hydrogens are missing here. So in this case, no alpha hydrogens available. Therefore, no tautomerism. Clear with the fact? Now let's move on to this very option. So I've got, again, what is the alpha carbon? That is the alpha carbon over here. Do you see any alpha hydrogen associated with it? Yes, I have got it. So it is here only. That is the alpha hydrogen present and it is definitely be going to give the tautomerism. I hope everybody has written this down. So can you draw the structure for that? Can you draw the structure for the enol form? I've got the keto form here. So just try to draw the enol form with me. So the enol form will be this hydrogen will migrate towards this oxygen and I need to then change the bonds. So what will it be? Simple. I hope everybody has got it right. So this will definitely be showing the keto-enol tautomerism. I hope everybody is clear with the fact. It's very, very easy. You just need to look out for the alpha hydrogens. Simple. Now, moving on to a very, very important concept over here, from which most of the questions are repeated. Finding out the enol content. So what is enol content? So the first question arises, what is this enol content? It is actually the amount of enol which is formed in the reaction mixture. So it is amount of enol formed . So I need to find out whether the enol content, whether the enol amount is more or less. So we have got questions based on that. I have got, let us just say two examples. More the number of alpha hydrogens, more the number of acidic hydrogens. Alpha hydrogen is nothing but acidic hydrogen. So more the number of acidic hydrogens, more is the enol content. So that will be the percentage of or the amount of enol which is formed. So if one hydrogen is there in a structure and in other structure I have got two hydrogens, so this will be at a higher priority. This will be having more enol content, more amount of enol formed in the structure. So I hope everybody is clear with it. So how to decide that how much enol content is there? So decided on the basis of number of alpha hydrogens. More the number of alpha hydrogens, more is the enol content, and that is it. I am just telling you only the main point over here to decide the enol concentration, and not all. I am not considering all of those. This is the most important one which is required in the questions. So it will be more the number of alpha hydrogens. You just need to count the number of alpha hydrogens and you get the answer. So let me just give you certain examples. Again, I'm taking up the example that I have taken up earlier. And so from these questions, I will be discussing one very important topic over here as well. So just pay very careful attention here. I'm taking up one more example. Let me just take up here. Now I've got how many? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So can you judge how many alpha hydrogens are there in each and every part? So let us just observe. Here if you see, alpha carbon is this one. There is one alpha hydrogen here in this case. One alpha hydrogen. Over here, how many? Three here, three here. That means six alpha hydrogens. Right? Now if I move on to over here. How many? This is the main carbon atom. Where is the alpha carbon? Here is the alpha carbon. So can you see an alpha hydrogen over here? Here is the hydrogen, we all know. This is the example of benzaldehyde, and you need to pay a very, very careful attention over here because I am just going to introduce one more topic. So that is the alpha hydrogen here, one alpha hydrogen. Over here, I've got three alpha hydrogens, we all know that. What else? I have got here, how many? This is the main carbon. This is what? A hydrogen will be there in the structure. So I've got two alpha hydrogens here. So now, what you need to do? Okay, let me just correct this a bit. In the case of benzaldehyde, benzaldehyde is like this. So if you observe over here, I've got, what is the alpha carbon? That is the alpha carbon. Is there a hydrogen present? So all the four valencies have been already occupied here for the carbon. I've got no alpha hydrogen. So there is. So just correct this up. No alpha hydrogen. Now, I've got benzaldehyde. This very compound over here is known as benzoquinone. Benzoquinone, very, very important example in the case of keto-enol tautomerism. Now, which one will be having the higher enol content? I need to find out. The one having higher number of hydrogens. So over here, this very particular group will be having the highest. So it has got highest enol content. I hope everybody is able to get this concept. Here I've got How many? One alpha hydrogen. Here no. So it will be no enol content. Over here I have got 3 and here I have got 2. So first is this one having highest number of alpha hydrogens. Next is this one having 3 alpha hydrogens. And what next you want to consider? You must be considering this. But just pay attention over here. This very compound is not going to give no enol formed. And I was telling you about one very important concept. So the concept is the alpha hydrogen which is there must be attached to saturated carbon. That means there must not be any kind of double bond or any kind of triple bond. I just need the hydrogen that is attached with singly bonded carbon. That means sp3 hybridized carbon. So here, just write this down, no enol content when alpha hydrogen is attached with unsaturated carbon. So here is a very important condition for ketoenol tautomerism, that the carbon should be saturated always and always. So here I am writing this down. The carbon should be saturated. Saturated carbon will be having the alpha hydrogen, and that alpha hydrogen will participate actively in the ketoenol tautomerism. I hope everybody is clear with the idea. So this very compound over here, benzoquinone, will not show tautomerism. I hope everybody is clear with the idea, because here the carbons over here are what? These are unsaturated. So clear with the fact? So what will be the order of enol content now? It will be 6, that is this acetone, followed by this, that is ethanol, and followed by this very compound over here. No such kind of a common name for this compound. So I hope everybody is clear with the fact. 6 alpha hydrogens followed by 3 followed by 1. So let me just write the answer over here. 6 alpha hydrogens followed by 3 alpha hydrogens followed by 1 alpha hydrogen, and that is our answer. So I hope it is clear to all. Now let's move on to one more important criteria, and the questions here will be very, very important. In the case of only the keto, the enol content that we are discussing. So let me just rub this off. I hope everybody has written this down. Now, enol content, what is the general scenario of enol content? What is the actual percentage of enol in normal ketoenol tautomerism? So what is it? So here I have got a very simple example. Again I am taking, this is ethanol. So this ethanol will be present in equilibrium. We all know how to find out the enol form. It will be like this. I hope everybody is able to make it. Now, I would like to tell you the information, very important information, that always the keto form is approximately 99%, whereas the enol form which is formed in the mixture is 1% or even less than 1%. So it is always 1% or even less than 1%. So this is the actual information of keto-enol tautomerism. So that is why there is equilibrium. Keto is always on higher priority keto group. So the keto form here is very stable. Keto is very stable in comparison with enol form. So that is enol form. Stable than the enol. Why it is so stable? So let us just discuss that. Why keto is more stable? Than enol. Why this is so? It's a very important question, and the main logic behind this question appears in the examination also. So just pay attention. Keto is always stable because in keto, I have got what? I've got this group, and in enol, I have got C double bond C, right? Here I'm not considering OH. Now, if you look here, this bond is slightly ionic. So this bond is slightly ionic. Why it is ionic? Due to the electronegativity of oxygen. So why ionic? Due to electronegativity of oxygen, this bond is slightly ionic. But if you see over here, this bond is completely covalent. So, here is a question for you. Which bond is more stable, ionic or covalent? So, I hope you have got the right answer. Always, it is the ionic bond. So, ionic bond is always stronger than the covalent bond. So, that is why the keto form having this particular bond will be more stable as compared to the one having C double bond C, that is covalent. So I hope everybody is clear with it, that why keto form in general is more stable than enol form. So here I'm writing out the reason. Ionic bond is always stable than the covalent bond. That is the only reason of more stability of keto than the enol form. So clear with the idea? This very idea over here is not followed. As we discuss in chemistry, every time in chemistry there are so many kinds of exceptions out there. So here in this particular topic, there is also one very important exception. The exception here is when enol form gets more stable than the keto form. So what is the exception? Let us just discuss that. So the exception here is, when the enol is more stable than keto. So this particular exception is followed in the case of, I have got two compounds. Pay attention. AA AAE. So these are the two compounds in which there is exception and very important compound also. So this is acetyl acetone, whereas this is acetoacetic ester. So clear with the fact, acetyl acetone, acetoacetic ester. So let us just draw the structures, very very easy structures. Acetyl acetone is 1,3-diketone, that means on to the 1 and 3 positions of carbon I want to attach 2 ketone groups. This is acetyl acetone. And what is acetoacetic ester? Quite a long name. So it is similar to acetyl acetone. The only change is this. Here we get an ester over here. Can I write this down again? It will be CH3, CH2, again a ketone and CH3. So this is the compound here. And what is the compound over here? That is nothing but the ester group. So these are the two compounds which actually serve as an exception. They are the exceptions. Why they are the exceptions? So let us just try to form the enol form. So here you have got alpha hydrogens, 3, 2, 3. So many alpha hydrogens. So again, if you see over here, 3, 2, and here there is no alpha hydrogen. So let us just try to draw the enol forms. So I am taking up in the case of AA, it will be this, which is the most acidic hydrogen. The most acidic is this, most acidic. Why? Because it is surrounded by two withdrawing carbonyls. That is why it can get removed very easily. So I hope everybody is getting me. Now I will perform what? Formation of enol. So just try to make with me simultaneously. It will be, I am representing this hydrogen like this, and let us just say it is migrated onto one of the oxygens. It cannot go on two oxygens, it cannot break into two halves. That is so simple, so logical. So it will be like this, a double bond here, hydrogen and CH3. Let me just remove this. I hope everybody has got the right enol. So this is the enol form. And if you look over here, there is a hydrogen bonding possible over here. So that is a hydrogen bonding. Hydrogen bonding, that is first. I am writing this structure again. So just look very carefully. So there is a hydrogen bonding. What will happen now? These electrons will shift here. This hydrogen will go there, and these electrons will again shift here. What is this? first is intramolecular H bonding. That is the first thing. Then what do I have? I have got, what is this going on? Why are the electrons shifting? And what is the process of shifting over here known as? This is nothing but, yes, this is resonance. So that is resonance. So both of these factors will conclude to a, will form a so stable structure. Resonance is stable. H bonding is always very stable. So both of the structure, both of the things will contribute to form a very, very stable structure. So this is very stable form. So that is why here the enol content is, the enol form is very stable and the enol content is higher. How much higher? It is slightly higher what we have in the previous case. It is more than 1%. It could be very much, even more than 10% also. So the enol content over here is always, always in the case of acetyl acetone. In the case of acetyl acetone, the enol content is always very, very stable. I hope everybody has got the idea here. So now let's just move on to a very simpler case, similar kind of a case, that is of acetoacetic ester. So here as well, what will there be? In the case of acetoacetic ester, again there will be, if I make this as the enol form and there is a double bond, so this is nothing but the enol form. Again, what will happen? I have got intramolecular H bonding. And what else? I have got again what? The resonance. So we have got the resonance as well. Clear? It is a similar case. So that is why here also the enol form is very stable. So I hope everybody has got the idea. Now the question is, out of the two enols, which is more stable? So let us just discuss this question as well. I've got AA enol. I've got AAE enol. AAE enol. So out of the two, which is more stable? So if you look very carefully, I'm just giving you the answer here. Enol of AA has got keto groups. But if you see over here, it is the ester group which is present. So here we have got ester group, and I would like to tell you a very important point over here, that ester group, and I can say the keto group is very much withdrawing group as compared to ester. So here it is more electron withdrawing group as compared to the ester. That means over here the hydrogen will get removed very easily in the case of AA, whereas in AAE it will be removed slowly. So here, since keto group is more withdrawing than the ester group, so I'm repeating it again, this group is more withdrawing than the ester group, so the acidic hydrogen here, acidic H here will be removed easily. So that is why out of the two forms, which is more stable? this is more stable. So I hope everybody has got the idea. And almost we are through with the topic of tautomerism. All the important points we have got covered. Let me just show you certain other examples which are related to the keto-enol tautomerism. These examples also show keto-enol. So let us just discuss that. So I've got an example of other examples. So I hope everybody has enjoyed the topic of tautomerism. Let us just move on to some other examples. I've got HCN. Now, instead of the alpha hydrogen, here what we have got is 1-2 migration of H. First thing. So what will be the 1-2 migration? That means here the hydrogen from the first carbon atom will be moved to the nitrogen. So that is how the tautomerism is taking place. And over here we are not going to call it as a keto-enol. It has got a different name. So it will be, okay. So that is something like this. What is this now? This is the cyanide form. This is the cyanide form. Clear? And this is nothing but isocyanide form. So in each and every case, you are having different kinds of names. Keto-enol is always considered when there is just one keto group present and we have got the enol of that. Over here, I am not writing it as keto-enol. So just be very careful while writing the names. Also, we have got such kind of isomerism, such kind of tautomerism in nitro groups as well as what is this molecule? This molecule is urea over here. So again, there is hydrogens. These hydrogens can migrate. So what will it be? It is a structure like this. So what will be the name of this form? You need to go and find out the names for all of these other special cases. We have discussed, we have covered almost 99% of the important part that is actually coming into your examinations, be it IITJ, be it NEET, be it CBSC. So you need to have a proper hold over this concept. Now it's the time for questions. So let us just discuss quickly the questions that I have. I hope everybody has followed the session very well. Now it's the time to test your knowledge. I've got question number one. Super easy, super simple. The enolic form of acetone contains. So first you need to form the enolic form of acetone. Are you able to draw it? I can. And I hope you can also. So that is the enol form. And they are asking what? They are asking how many sigma bonds are there? How many pi bonds are there? How many lone pairs are there? So let us just try to count. So enol form is this. This is keto. I'm concerned with this very particular form. So here I've got 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 sigma bonds. Do not try to count this pi bond over here. So here I've got 9 sigma bonds. I hope everybody has got 9 sigma bonds here. So I've got two options which may be having an answer. Now I need to count the pi bond and it will give our answer. So here I've got how many pi bonds? Just one pi bond, and I get my answer over here, that is A. Need not go into the detail of the lone pairs. Also, you can count the lone pairs. It's super easy. Now I hope you are able to do the questions related to tautomerism. Let's move on to the next question. Now, it's a special kind of a question over here. Which among the given molecules can exhibit tautomerism? So I need to find out which molecule can have tautomerism. So here it is a special case. Why this is I'm saying? If you see over here, there is a bridge. Now, I need to count the alpha hydrogens. So what are the alpha hydrogens present? This is the keto group. Here it will be a alpha hydrogen. Here it will be 2. Over here it will be 1. Here there is no alpha hydrogen. Over here I've got 1 here and 1 here. So which molecule will give the tautomerism? Can you find out? Actually, not all molecules. The molecules which are having the alpha hydrogens on the bridge, they cannot get removed, because if they get removed, the bridge will break. So here, the alpha hydrogen on bridge is not removed, because the bridge will break. So, because the bridge will break, I hope everybody is getting the idea. This is a special case which I have discussed over here. So, this molecule over here cannot give the tautomerism. Over here, I have got just one alpha hydrogen and that too on the bridge. That means this cannot also give the tautomerism. And over here, if you see, I've got one bridge one. This will not give, but the hydrogens over here can give. That means I've got my answer. Number 3 compound will be giving the tautomerism. So I hope everybody's got the idea. Now let's move on to the very last question. What do I have? So the next question and the last question says, okay, which one of the following compounds cannot show tautomerism? You need to find out which will not show the tautomerism. Let us just strike out the answer. So here it has got alpha hydrogens. It will give, this is acetone on the B. If you see very carefully, what is this form? This is the enol form. So this will give. Look here carefully. Again, I've got 2 alpha hydrogens. That means this will also give. And look over here. I've got 1 alpha hydrogen here. Is this molecule able to give tautomerism? So if you see very carefully, this hydrogen is attached with unsaturated carbon. Therefore, it is not capable of giving the tautomerism. I need to have a saturated carbon. I hope everybody is recalling the concept now. And lastly, I have got 2 hydrogens here, and this very hydrogen can also give tautomerism, just as I had discussed in the case of urea. So I hope everybody is clear with the concept. The answer is D, because I needed to find out those who cannot show tautomerism. So finally, we are through with the topic. I hope you have enjoyed the session, and most importantly, you are now able to do the questions of tautomerism on your own. So just try to practice more and more questions from this very topic. It is quite important. And also, I would like to tell you over here is, you can refer our website of mesostudy.com in order to purchase the study material. We have got free ebooks as well. along with the study material that you are going to purchase. And we have got certain good offers going on right now. So just rush to our website and subscribe. Thank you.